We're about to end this real quick, but I want to say something about this song. Don't let anybody tell you, religious, you know, pious, sanctimonious, don't let anybody tell you that it takes more to than the cross to be saved. I mean, listen, I grew up in church, in the Pentecostal church, so I know a lot of you understand what I mean when I say this, is that a lot of people try to add stuff on and, you know, so that you can meet up to their standards and to their mentality of what's saved and sanctified and holy and all that kind of stuff. But let me say this to you. Everything changed at the cross. The cross is the single greatest love letter that God has ever written to mankind. And what he did through Jesus Christ on the cross, he signed it in blood once and for all. That's what Hebrews says, once and for all. So listen, let them, you know, they can have their long dresses and have their no makeup and have their no earrings or whatever. Let them keep that. You let them keep the argument because you've got the evidence. Watch this, that it only took the cross and you coming there to be saved. And everything changed there at the cross. New life began there at the cross alone.
Built a table, spread a tree that grew. A life was spent between two thrones. Justice was placed before the world. Amazing grace. Oh, how I'm drawn to the cross alone, the place for mercy and sin atoned. The place where my sins met their end. Everything changed there. The cross alone. New life begins there. The cross alone. A rugged peace. Hey. Of justice too. A carpenter. A Christ that would give up his
the church, especially those about the cross. We've got two right here. So
there and made them right. Thank you, Lord, propitiation from perfect love. There's still yet room there. Will there be one? Just
there is room at the cross for you.
Come, come wherever you are. There's still room at the cross.